Hello friends, now we'll be starting the next topic, that is test on subgrade soil. There are various types of tests which should be conducted on subgrade soil. Most of this covered in geotechnical engineering. The first four, that is direct shear test, which is used to be conducted for sandy soil, and confined compressive strength or unconfined compressive strength, when shear test or triaxial test. When shear test is a in situ test used for field testing, and these both are laboratory testing. So I will not explain this 1, 2, and 3, 4 test as it is covered in geotechnical engineering. As per highway perspective, these three steps plays a major role for evaluation of subgrade soil, that is California bearing ratio CBR, plate bearing test or plate load test, and last is direct cone penetration test. The first and second, that is California bearing ratio and plate bearing test, is explained in detail in the further slides. I will just give a small introduction or a brief for direct cone penetration test. Direct cone penetration, as the name suggests, it has a cone in it. Cone is at the bottom. This type of equipment is there. Here there is a cone at the bottom with a 60-degree angle of the cone, and there is a stand here over here, and a rammer is there. A rammer or a hammer, you can say, is to be rammed on this rod. And the cone penetrates in the soil. For each blow of the hammer is of 8 kg, and the height of the hammer fall is around half a meter. Then each blow for the penetration is measured, and what penetration is done for each number of blow is counted. And a graph is plotted for a blow, number of blows and penetration in mm, and depending upon that the soil quality is classified or it is measured. These two are explained in the next slides. So before entering into the test, the tests are classified into three types. The test used to evaluate the strength properties of the soil may be broadly divided into three groups. First is shear test, bearing test, and last is penetration test. Shear tests are usually carried out on a relatively small soil samples in the laboratory. In order to find out the strength properties of a soil, a number of representative samples from different isolations are tested, for different locations are tested. Some of these commonly known shear tests are a direct shear test, triaxial compressive compression test, and unconfined compression test. These three are the basics of geotechnical engineering. Bearing test. Bearing tests are loading tests carried out on a subgrade soil in situ with a load bearing area. The results of the bearing test are influenced by variations in the soil properties within the stressed soil mass underneath, and hence the overall stability of the part of the soil or soil mass is stressed. The last is penetration test. Penetration test may be considered as small scale bearing test in which the size of the loaded area is relatively much smaller and the ratio of the penetration to the size of the loaded area is much greater than the ratios in bearing test. The penetration tests are carried out in the field or in lab. Now we will be starting California bearing test. This is one of the important tests for highway engineering. As you can see, CBR is the boon for highway material testing. It is a quite old method, but still it is used and effective. California bearing ratio CBR was developed by California Division of Highway as a method of classifying and evaluating soil subgrade and base course material for flexible pavements. CBR test, an empirical test, has been used to determine the material properties for pavement design. empirical test measures the strength of the material and are not a true representative of resilient modulus. It is a penetration test wherein a standard piston having an area of 19.62 cm square, that is 50 mm dia, is used to penetrate the soil at a standard rate of 1.25 mm per minute. It means the CBR is a penetration test, as the 50 mm dia hammer or rammer of an area 19.62 is penetrated on a soil at a standard rate of 1.25 mm per minute. The pressure up to a penetration of 12.5 mm and its ratio to the bearing value of standard crushed rock is termed as the standard CBR. It means it is the ratio of it is a ratio of the standard soil. So what is a standard soil? Here in this CBR method, standard soil is the crushed rocks, and whatever the soil samples are there from various places, whatever the penetration for this soil sample is compared to the penetration of the standard standard soil, that is crushed rocks, at penetration of 12.5 mm. So this is the ratio, it is CBR ratio, the sample soil upon the standard soil penetration. The ratio of 2.5 mm penetration is used as the CBR. In some cases, the ratio of 5 mm may be greater than 2.5 mm. Mostly 2.5 mm is considered as a penetration, 2.5 mm penetration is considered as a CBR value. But in some cases, the 5 mm penetration is greater than the 2.5 mm penetration. If this occurs, the ratio of 5 mm should be used in confirmly by repeating the test. Means if 5 mm penetration CBR is greater than 2.5 mm penetration, then the test is again repeated. The CBR is measured of resistance of material to penetration to the standard plunger under controlled density and moisture condition. The CBR test is performed on a controlled density and a standard plunger is used, that is 50 mm dia plunger. Here I have said that if 5 mm penetration, that is CBR of 5 mm is greater than 2.5 after repeating the test also, then the greater, that is the 5 mm CBR, which is greater than 2.5, is considered. I will let this clear again. The 2.5 mm penetration is considered as a CBR, but if 5 mm penetration CBR is greater than 2.5 mm after performing the test also, then the 5 mm penetration is taken as a CBR value. The test may be conducted in remolded or undisturbed specimen in laboratory. It is extensively used for the field correlation flexible pavement thickness requirement. As I have said, this is widely used, and this is the boon for highway engineering, the CBR test. So, test procedure of CBR. The laboratory CBR apparatus consists of a mold 150 mm dia with a base plate and a collar. The loading frame and dial gauges for measuring the penetration values and the expansion on soaking. The specimen in the mold is soaked in water for 4 days, and the swelling and the water absorption test are noted. Water absorption values are noted. Load is applied on the sample by a standard plunger of dia 50 mm at a rate of 1.25 mm per minute. A load penetration curve is drawn. The load values on standard crushed stones are 1370 kg, that is 70 kg per centimeter square, and 2055 kg, that is 105 kg per centimeter square at 2.5 mm and 5 mm penetration respectively. These are the standard values for the crushed stones, or the crushed stones values. Load values for the standard crushed stones. CBR value is expressed as a percentage of the actual load causing the penetration of 2.5 mm or 5 mm to the standard load mentioned above. Therefore, CBR is equal to load carried by a specimen, any soil specimen, upon load carried by a standard specimen, that is a crushed stones aggregate, into 100. Two values of CBR will be obtained. If the value of 2.5 mm is greater than 5 mm penetration, the former is adopted. That is, the 2.5 mm values which is greater is adopted. If the CBR value obtained from test at 5 mm penetration is higher than the 2.5 mm, then the test is to be repeated for checking. If the check test again gives similar result, then higher value adopted at 5 mm penetration is reported as a CBR value. That is, after performing the test again also, the 5 mm penetration is greater than 2.5 mm penetration, then the 5 mm penetration is reported as a CBR value. The average CBR value for 3 test specimen is reported as a CBR value for the sample. As the only one single sample is not sufficient for the accuracy, so 3 test samples are performed, and the average of the 3 samples is taken as a CBR value for more accuracy. So in this diagram, I have shown this is a mold here with a soil sample. The mold is of dia 150 mm and 127 mm height. This is a surcharge weight placed over the soil samples. This is a penetration plunger 50 mm dia, and the dial gauge for measuring the penetration is attached here. The same is here. This is a dial gauge. This is a dial gauge for penetration noting. This is a mold with 150 mm dia. This is a plunger. And these are the surcharge weights. If the specimen has surface irregularities, the initial portion of the curve may have concavity upwards. That is, after plotting of load penetration curve, this is a discussion of that load penetration curve. In this case, the tangent is drawn to the curve at the point of greatest slope. Curve is shown in the figure below. This tangent plus the convex portion of the original curve in the corrected curve, with the origin moved to the point where the tangent curve cuts the x-axis. I will explain in the graph here. So here the load on the y-axis in kgs and penetration in the x-axis in mm is plotted. This is called the load penetration curve. Curve number 1, here the concavity is downward. So here you can see there is concavity in downwards and convexity in the upward direction. This is a perfect curve, so there is no need of any correction. This point represents the 75 mm load and the penetration of 3 mm approx. And the second curve is there, which needs correction. Here in this curve, there is concavity upward. As in this case, there is concavity downward. But in this case, there is concavity upward. So this type of curve needs correction. So what type of correction we will do in this graph is, a straight line at this curve, this concavity curve, with having the maximum slope is drawn. A tangent is drawn at this curve, which will intersect the x-axis. This dashed line, you can see this, is intersecting the, a tangent is drawn, this is dashed and is a tangent, this will intersect the x-axis. And the new corrected curve will be starting at the origin, will be shifted from the point of intersection at the x-axis. So in this curve, where no need of correction, the origin is zero over here only. But when the correction is needed, then the tangent is drawn at the maximum slope, that is the concavity upward slope, and where the point intersects the x-axis will be considered as the new origin. The typical CBR values for soil and their rating. So first, soil is divided into a clay, silt and sand, clay, silt, sand and gravel. Range of the CBR is, a clay has a very low CBR value. That is why clay is not used for the subgrade soil, which is 2 to 5. It is very, very poor subgrade. Silt is having 5 to 8 CBR, poor subgrade. And sand is having 8 to 20 CBR, which is fair or good type of subgrade, you can say. And gravel is having a very high CBR. With 20 to 30 CBR is an excellent subgrade. 30 to 60 is good subgrade, good subbase. and 6280 is good base, and 8200 is best base. As the percentage of CBR is higher, it is considered as a good quality of soil. Here I have given an example for CBR. The load and penetration values for the CBR test are given below. Calculate the CBR value. The penetration is increasing by the penetration is in an increment of 0.5 mm, 0.51, 1.5 up till 12.5, and the load in kgs is 0.7, 24, 41 in respective penetration. By this table, I have drawn a load and penetration curve here. Load and penetration curve. So after plotting the points and the joining the points, a curve is representing over here, which is a curve 2, that is which needs correction over here because there is concavity part upward. So that is why a straight tangent is drawn at the maximum slope area, which intersects the x-axis at 0.25 mm. So I have given here the load penetration curve is plotted in figure 2, which is curve number 2, which needs correction. The observation needs correction. The tangent to the curve meets the x-axis at a value of 0.25 mm. The origin needs shifting by this amount, means the origin from origin, the first origin is 0, it should be shifted to 0.25 mm. Thus the loads at 2.5 mm and 5 mm penetration are 74 and 115 kg respectively. Now after shifting the origin, the 2.5 and 5 mm penetration will also be shifted, that is 2.5 mm penetration is now a 2.75 mm penetration, and 5 mm penetration is now a 5.25 mm penetration because the origin is shifted from 0 to 0.25. And the, what are the load values corresponding to this 5.25 and 2.75 is the loading condition of that penetration, which is given here 2.5, it is 74, and 5 mm, it is 111 kg. A CBR value for 2.5 mm penetration is 74 upon 1370. This is the standard values for the crust aggregates. CBR value for standard soil. 2.5 mm penetration is 74 kg and 5 mm penetration is 111 kg, which gives the same value for both 2.5 and 5, that is 5.4 percentage CBR. The CBR value is 5.4%. As both the 2.5 and 5 mm penetration are same, the higher or lower is both are the same, so 5.4 is the CBR value. Now in this case, if 5 mm penetration is greater than 2.5 mm penetration, then the test is again repeated, and again if the 5 mm penetration is greater than 2.5 mm penetration, then the 5 mm penetration is adopted as a CBR value. Plate bearing test. Plate bearing test is used to evaluate the supports of subgrid. This is also an important test after CBR. This is used to evaluate the support for subgrid, base, and in some cases complete pavement. Data for the test are applicable for the design for both flexible and rigid pavement. In plate bearing test, a compressive stress is applied to the soil or pavement layers through rigid plates respectively. Large size and deflections are measured for various stress values. Test procedure. The test site is prepared and loose material is removed so that the 75 mm diameter plate rests completely in full contact with the soil subgrid. This is a standard plate adopted for a plate load testing or plate bearing test. The plate is seated accurately, and then seating load equivalency to the pressure of 0.07 kg per centimeter square, that is 320 kg to 75 centimeter dia plate. A pressure is allotted to this plate. The pressure is applied and then again released after a few seconds. The settlement dial gauge is now to be zero load. The load is applied by means of jack sufficient to cause an average settlement about 0.25 cm. When there is no perceptible increase settlement, or when rate settlement or when the rate of settlement is less than 0.025 mm per minute. In this case of soil with high moisture content or in clay soil, the load dial reading and the settlement dial readings are noted. That is, after applying a load on that plate, the settlement is noted and a load and the settlement readings are plotted. Deflection of the plate is measured by means of deflection dials placed usually on 1/3 point of the plate near its outer edge. To minimize bending, a series of stacked plates should be used. I will show in this diagram another of three or four settlement dial readings is taken at the settlement of the plate corresponding to the applied load. Load is then increased till the average settlement increases to a further amount of about 0.25 mm and the load and the average settlement readings are noted as before. The procedure is repeated until the settlement is about 1.75 mm or above. Allowance for worst subgrade moisture and moisture correction for small plate should be dealt properly. As the subgrade testing is there, the moisture is there in the soil, so proper soil moisture correction is applied for the plate load test. For worst moisture condition of subgrade, an unsoaked and other soaked samples of the soil is taken and pressure required to cause settlement of 0.125 cm is noted in both. So 0.125 cm settlement is noted, and what are the pressure corresponding to this is noted again. Hence, K soaked is equal to K unsoaked upon pressure at unsoaked into pressure at soaked. K soaked is the modulus of subgrade reaction for soaked condition and K unsoaked the modulus of subgrade reaction for unsoaked condition. P soaked is the pressure required to produce 0.125 settlement in soaked samples. So here there is a reaction of loaded truck, that is a loading. This is a jack type arrangement. This is a pressure gauge to measure the pressure. This is a dial gauge to measure the deflection. This is a hydraulic jack. The bottom is the 75 mm plate, 75 centimeter dia plate, and these are the assemblies of the plate and these are the subgrade soil. As you can see here, this is a jack type arrangement here for the loading condition. The bottom plate is 75 centimeter dia plate, and this is subgrade soil. And two jacks which are used for loading measurement and settlement or penetration measurement. So the whole theory which I have talked about is covered in this one graph. So as load penetration graph is plotted in CBR, the same pressure and settlement graph is plotted for plate load test. The mean settlement is on x-axis and the mean bearing pressure is on the y-axis. A same type of graph or same type of pattern you can see here. So a settlement of 1.25 mm is noted, means at what pressure the settlement is 1.25 mm, which is noted, that is 8 mn per meter square. Mn is mega newton per meter square. So here 8 mn per meter square is the pressure for 1.25 mm settlement. So here most important topic in subgrade, that is K. I will introduce here K, which plays an important role in subgrade. K is the modulus of subgrade reaction. This K, it is the most important topic. K is equal to modulus of subgrade reaction. It is nothing but the slope of this line. As the settlement pressure goes on increasing, the settlement also goes on increasing. So there is a linear type of graph pattern observed. So K is nothing but the slope, that is load upon settlement. Here load is 8 mm per meter square and settlement is 1.25 mm. Therefore K is equal to pressure upon settlement. So remember one thing, 1.25 mm settlement is noted for load penetration test calculation. The graph is plotted with the mean settlement versus bearing pressure, that is load per unit area, as shown in the figure in the graph. The pressure corresponding to a settlement is obtained from this graph. The modulus of subgrade reaction is calculated from the reaction, that is pressure upon the penetration or the settlement, that is kg per centimeter square per centimeter. This is a unit of modulus of subgrade reaction. The load settlement curve figure should theoretically be a straight line, and its slope should give the value of k. But to get a curved relationship in which each k is determined by drawing a straight line through the origin and a point on the curve corresponding to a settlement of 1.25 mm. The k is the loading pressure corresponding to the settlement of 1.25 mm, that is p upon 1.25. If you want to calculate k, that is modulus of subgrade, what pressure is at 1.25 centimeter settlement is noted. So here in this case, it is 8 mm per meter square for 1.25 mm settlement. So this is the k value, modulus of subgrade reaction. If a 30 centimeter dia plate is used, a rough correction between the k value obtained using 75 centimeter diameter plate and the k values obtained using 30 centimeter dia plate is given by 75 centimeter dia plate is a standard plate used for plate load test. Now if I use a 30 centimeter dia plate, what will be the correction or what will be the relation? The theoretical relationship can be derived to deal with the problems of the above nature. When a rigid circular plate loaded on a soil of elastic properties, the settlement is given by delta is equal to 1.18 Pa upon E. This is a formula for settlement for rigid circular plate. Now, since K is equal to pressure upon delta, we will get K is equal to E upon 1.18 A, where E belongs to the modulus of elasticity of the plate and the being the diameter of the plate, and A is the diameter of the plate and E is the modulus of subgrade reaction. K is equal to E upon 1.18, A is the diameter of the plate and E is the modulus of elasticity of the plate. It thus follows that K1A1 is equal to K2A2, that is E upon 1.18 is constant. When the subscript 1 and 2 refers to values with test and plate of different diameter, then K75, that is modulus of subgrade reaction at for 75 mm dia plate into 75, which is the diameter of that plate, is equal to modulus of subgrade reaction for 30 mm diameter plate into 30 mm. This is the constant for when we derive a relation for 75 centimeter plate penetration and 30 centimeter plate relation. I will take an example for this. Plate bearing test conducted on a 30 cm dia plate yielding the following observation. Determine the K value corresponding to a plate of 75 cm dia. 75 cm dia is adopted as a standard plate. So a 30 cm dia plate is used for the testing, and these load penetration or load settlement values are derived from that experiment. So we have to find the K value for 75 cm dia. This is a relation. It means after obtaining the K30, by this relation we can easily obtain K75, which is asked in this question. This loading is the experiment for 30 cm by using 30 cm dia plate. At the settlement of 1.25 mm, load is 1260 kg. That is, settlement of 1.25 mm is considered for plate load test. So 1.25 mm settlement, the load is 1260 kg. That is here 1260 kg. Now what is the loading stress? Loading stress P is equal to 1260 upon pi d square by 4. That is pi by 4 is this value, 0.7854 pi by 4. And d square means the diameter, that is 30, pi d square by 4. Into 9.81, that is if we have to convert the kgs into newton, we will multiply the kg by 9.81 and we will get the answer in Newton. So by applying this equation or by calculation this, we will get a value of 0.715 mega Newton per meter square per meter. The settlement was in mm and kg and the weight was in kg. So kg is converted into Newton and mm is converted into meter. So the value of P is equal to, that is loading is equal, loading stress is equal to 0.715 mn per meter square per meter. Now K, that is modulus of subgrade reaction, is equal to P upon 1.25. Here P is equal to 0.715 upon 1.25 into 1000 mn per meter square per meter. It will be the K value will be 140 mega Newton per meter square per meter. This value is for 30 centimeter dia. You have to find for 75 centimeter dia plate. So 75 centimeter, by using this relation, we know this value K 30. We have calculated this value K 30. Now by using this equation, I will easily get K 75. That is modulus of subgrade reaction for 75 centimeter diameter plate, which is 56 mega Newton per meter square per meter. So thank you friends for watching. This was the end of the important testings on soil subgrade. We have studied two major testing, that is first is CBR, California bearing ratio, and the second is plate load test. These two is the major or the most important testing in soil subgrade. So thank you for watching friends.